How's it gangin', dudes? My name is Sean and welcome back to my channel, where normally we poke a little fun at the mainstream media, but today, as much as a partisan hack as Stephen Colbert has, turned into from what he used to be, all right, I have to say that, it's pretty much a fair and cordial interview. I think it's now because they think that Yang's not a threat, even though everybody's ignoring that he's rising into the polls. But he goes on to the Late Show to slam the DNC, slams them hard, live on air, to all of the boomers across the world who would normally just see something on the news and take it wholeheartedly. Oh, Yang went in the debate. Oh, okay, guess he's out, right? No. If anything, he's pulling higher and rising and rising. So I want to get into it. We're going to take this clip by clip. That way we don't, they don't copyright it. Because that's how it happens. So make sure you smack a like. Pour some gravy on this algorithm. The algorithm loves gravy. The overlords demand the gravy, okay? So gravy equals like. And if you want some mashed potatoes with the gravy, you gotta drop a share. It's just the way it is. You know, it's just the life of the YouTubes, okay? All right, so let's get right in this. Okay. So this is coming up real quick, too. Okay, I can't contain myself. Let's just do it.
Folks, my first guest tonight is a tech entrepreneur who's currently running for president. Please welcome back to The Late Show, Andrew Yang. That's nice. I love the bounding off of the youthful energy.
Okay, so immediately you'll notice that even Colbert knows that he's youthful, he's energized, he's happy, he's having the most time out of all the candidates. And, you know, of course, Joe Biden and Bernie Sanders and Elizabeth Warren, they're all, saunter on stage like they're zombified corpses, because that's pretty much what they are, right? I just wanted to touch base with you a little bit on that, because a lot of people don't really take notice about it. Now, it's in the psyche of everybody's minds, right? That, oh, wow, he is a young guy. But nobody really connects that this young guy has better ideas than most of the old people. Okay, so now we're getting ready to get into the, where he kind of hurts the DNC pretty hard, man. I don't think they're so, because he did that, I think the DNC is going to be coming out hard on him, but they've never been, they haven't been friendly towards us anyways, you know what I mean? So it doesn't really matter. And we're rising in the polls despite all of that, because most of our base is young, and most of the young doesn't get polled, because 20% internet polling and 80% landline polling. Anyways, let's continue.
Can I ask you a question? I saw you responding to the crowd right there, and you know how to work a crowd really well and get people excited. When did it first occur to you that you wanted to run or become president of the United States? Because it's not just the office, it's everything you have to do while you're running for president that almost nobody is prepared to do.
I would never have thought of running for president if Donald Trump had not won in 2016.
Would you like to thank him? Would you like to take a moment out and thank him for inspiring you?
I'm happy to thank him for keeping that seat warm long enough for me to come beat him in just 9-10 months.
Now, Stephen Colbert, he just glosses right over that. He glosses right over the fact that Yang is the only person prepared to go toe-to-toe with memes on Trump, to go toe-to-toe with haha, I got you. Look, oh, you got mega, I got math. He will come out with fire with Trump, and that's what you got to do to defeat him, while Biden will just cave and Elizabeth Warren and then you'll have Bernie says, the millionaires and the billionaires and my finger won't stop a shaking, and that's all that they'll do to Trump, and Trump will just be like, oh, he's a socialist, oh, Biden the red eye, and then, oh, Elizabeth Warren, who is her, oh, Pocahontas, you know, that's how that will work. So I have to say that everybody glosses over that, but Yang's just out there just like, look, keep that seat warm for me, buddy. Keep it warm. I love it.
You weren't in the debate last night. No news to you, but maybe to some of the people out there. Why weren't you in the debate?
Well, we were at the right polling threshold in the country and three of the four early states. They just didn't run enough polls in those states ahead of qualification?
Because there are criteria set by the DNC, and it's fundraising. Did you meet the fundraising goal?
Oh, yeah. We blew past the fundraising threshold by a country mile weeks ago.
But you didn't make all the thresholds for polling.
Yeah, so we were there in Iowa. We were there nationwide. They just hadn't run polls in the early states for a month and a half. And because of that, we just ran out of time before the deadline.
Man, Yang came out strong on that. Of course, he's nice and cordial about it, but at the same time, you could see he laughs in the beginning. It was an expertly worded attack on the DNC on the Late Show, where they have a lot of viewers who get who tend to be polled because they're older folk, right? And who have landline phones. So that was very smart to do to bring out and expose the DNC for the antics that they did. Yes, he met requirements on all the polls that they need. The only polls that he didn't meet the requirements on were the ones that they chose. and then on top of that, like he said, for a month and a half, polls were dry. There was no polls. When historically, every single time, there's always been new polls after each debate. You know what I mean? So it was arbitrary, man. It was arbitrary, and it's probably going to happen again. I'm not going to lie, but it doesn't matter. And Stephen Colbert is getting ready to explain that. He's getting ready to say that it does not matter. But the thing is, Stephen Colbert doesn't connect those two things. He doesn't connect that the DNC is rigging it against him. And they'll say, oh, well, they're allowed to rig it. It's their, you know, they're not a government entity. They're a company, so they're allowed to. Yeah, but if you can't just arbitrarily change your roles constantly. There's no. First of all, there's no morality in that. There's no ethics in that. And second of all, or third of all, even my bad, there's no reason to do that. It makes you look bad. There is no support in the DNC. Nobody believes the DNC. Nobody. Nobody does. Like, they're so blatant in the obvious stuff that they do, and Yang just exposes them. It's excellent. I love it. I love it. All right, so let's continue for what he's getting ready to say, and then we'll do a little more on the analysis after that.
Does it matter if you're in the debate or not? Does it matter to the Yang Gang? Or does it sort of just inspire the Yang Gang to work harder? Or do you have to move beyond the Yang Gang to the general Uber Gang of America?
The Gang of America.
Yes.
Well, certainly I would have loved to have been on the stage last night. Mm-hmm. Any opportunity to address the American people is a great opportunity.
Well, there's no better opportunity than right here, right now. So let me ask you the first question that Wolf Blitzer asked last night. This is the first question Wolf asked last night. Why are you best prepared to be commander in chief?
All right, guys, I'm gonna leave it there. Go to Andrew Yang's page, his channel, you know, his YouTube, if you want to see the rest of this interview. I want to leave it there just because it's the channel, or the video is literally focused just on him calling out the DNC. And on top of that, if I keep going clip for clip for clip, they're going to claim this video. There's no other way around it. I don't want that to happen because I want this to get out to you guys. But Stephen Colbert is right. There is no better way to address the people, especially the people the DNC are getting a hold of. That's the same audience I was just saying. But the Yang Gang is in the audience. You can hear that, right? Oh, man, that was so great. That was excellent. So, yes, Yang is rising in the polls. He's doing so much better. That was the best thing for him to happen to him was to not be on that debate. I don't know, his search results are staying high, everything. And if you look historically, when candidates keep fundraising, they keep having historically huge fundraising hauls, the other trajectory of them gaining in polls, usually they have usually a same trajectory. The lines usually both go up or both go down. They tend to stay together. And DNC is trying as hard as they can to make it not look that way. Like you said, he blew past it with a country mile, man. So, oh, man, it was just... This is great. I've said a million times, you know, even if Yang doesn't become president, he's a celebrity now, man. He is going to be a mainstay in politics for years to come. If we don't get our ideas in this time, it doesn't matter. We're going to be here for next time. This is a movement that's not going to die anytime soon. We're going to get him at least into late spring. And guess what? If he comes in third, fourth in some of these polls, He has a chance to win it all and shock the world, like he says. So don't listen to any of the naysayers, guys. Don't let nobody be like, oh, well, he doesn't have a chance, so you have to vote. Like, no, you always vote your conscience. Always vote your morals. Always vote your ethics. Don't vote just because, oh, we don't like this guy. He's not on the same team as us. Even if it is Donald Trump, it does not matter. Always vote your conscience. So that's today's message, guys. I hope you guys like it. I hope you guys drop some gravy, you know, some mashed potatoes. And I'll see you guys in the next one, man.